sector of Indian economy. I'm audible. Sectors of Indian economy, national economy. Generally, there are a different number of activities which generally done by the people for the earning of their livelihoods. Such number of activities are not possible to study or calculate for the calculation of a GDP, because all these activities are included under the GDP of a country, gross domestic product. All these are included under the GDP of our country. In national income of our country, all these are calculated, but it's not possible to calculate them as the separately. For the study of a such number of activities, all those activities which done by the people for the earning of their livelihoods, all these activities are generally classified into the sectors in categories, in certain categories. Such categories are the sectors. Such sectors through which, through the study of such sectors, we can improve or develop such number of sectors by the investment. Investment by the government or foreign direct investment from other countries of the world. So broadly, there are sectors. They are divided into the three categories. There are three categories of sectors which are present in our country. First, on the basis of production. On the basis of production are types of activities. There are three types of the sectors are there. Primary sector, secondary sector, and tertiary sector, primary sector, secondary sector, and tertiary sector. All these are based upon a production or type of a product. Product in the sense, whatever which has produced from a such number of a categories, primary, secondary, and tertiary. Now the second category is on the basis of working conditions. On the basis of working conditions. There are two types of the sectors are there, organized and unorganized. Organized sector and unorganized sector. Unorganized sector. When we are talking about the organized sector, one term comes in our mind as that sector which basically run by or administered by the government. But there are some number of private owners, private companies are also there, which are following the rules and regulations marked by the government. Rules and regulations in the sense, minimum wages. Those minimum wages which are set as per the law, these number of institutes, either they are administered by the private individuals or a group of individuals, they are also following the as such thing. Those services which are providing by the government sector, they are also providing by the such number of private institutes also. Clear? And second as the unorganized, which do not follow the government rules and regulations, where the workers exploited by the employers. We will discuss about them in detail. Now the third category is on the basis of ownership. On the basis of ownership, there are three types of sectors are there. Public sector, second private sector, and third joint sector. This is as the broader categorization of all those number of activities which generally done by the people for earning of their livelihoods. I'm repeating again, on the basis of production or a type of a product, there are three activities, primary, secondary, and tertiary. On the basis of working conditions of the workers, laborers, there are two sectors, organized and unorganized. And third, on the basis of ownership, public, private, and joint sector. Public, private, and joint sector. Clear? Yes, Amritpal.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning. Clear? So, transformation of raw materials into the finished goods, that's why this sector is known as the manufacturing sector. Secondary sector is based upon the, it is based upon the primary sector activities. Example, electricity. Why electricity? Because in a hydel power stations, water which produced to the primary sector, it has used as a raw material for generation of a power. Electricity. Second, manufacturing industries like as a cotton textile industries, iron and steel industries, aluminium smelting centers. Clear? Oil refineries. Third, construction. Through the process of a construction, we build as the residential apartments. Residential apartments require as a inputs which are produced through the primary activities, like as a brick, like as a sand, cement. All these are used in a making of a residential buildings. So construction activities are included under the manufacturing. Construction activities, electricity, construction activities, manufacturing activities are includes under the manufacturing activities. When primary goods are used to produce some other commodity, then the activity is known as the manufacturing. Clear? Third sector of economy is a tertiary sector. This is known as a service sector, because it provide as the basic services for the growth in primary and secondary sectors. So all such services are necessary for the production in a primary and secondary sectors. For example, those goods which produce in primary sector as agricultural products, these transported towards the markets through the means of transport. Transport is a service. For the production of a crops, we require a money. Farmers require a money. That money provided by the banks is a service. Banking is a service. Insurance is a service. Clear? Broadly, these services are divided into two categories. There are two categories of the services are there. Basic services and infrastructural services. Basic services includes health, means hospitals, health education, water supply, and infrastructural services includes transport, communication, marketing, trade, commerce, banking, insurance, etc. Clear? Banking, insurance, etc. We use the transport to carry agriculture crops from agriculture fields towards the factory. We also use the transport to carry the materials after the manufacturing of the materials in industries like as a sugar or a cotton garments. They move towards the markets through the means of a transport. For the setup the newer firms, we require a money. That money lended by the banks, insurance giving through the insurance, through insurance development. Development is generally based upon infrastructural services like transport. Industrialists investing their money in such number of the societies or areas where such infrastructure services provided by the government at low cost or free of cost. For example, transport, means of transport, communication, trade facilities. India opted the policy of a liberalization in the 1990s, liberalization and globalization in 1990s, which encouraged the growth of a foreign direct investment. There, banking, insurance, marketing. If the goods are produced or not sold in a market, then how can the industrialists, they will earn the profits? So for them, the marketing, it's also as includes under the infrastructural services. I'm repeating again, the trade, commerce, banking, insurance, marketing, etc. All these are the services. Tertiary sector as known the service sector. So there are the some of the people which are engaged in a service sector as the teachers. They are neither producing as a goods. Goods are only produced in a primary and a secondary sectors. So the people which are engaged in a tertiary sector are teachers, doctors, engineers, barbers, that kabadi wala, which generally coming towards our streets every day, kabadi wala, it's also are providing us a service, milkman providing us a service, milkman, newspaper man, all these vegetable vendor, all these are providing us the services. They neither produce the goods. They provide us the services. Clear? Any questions still there? Primary, secondary, and tertiary. The type of a production, it is often useful to aggregate the production that passes through the nation's markets into the three broad classes of a primary, secondary, and tertiary. Primary sector includes as the harvesting of a natural resources, especially the agriculture crops, fish, forest, minerals, and sources of energy such as the coal, oil, and natural gas. These provide as the foodstuffs, basic raw materials, and power on which other production depends. The secondary sector comprises all of manufacturing and construction activities. The tertiary sector covers the production of all services such as transport, entertainment, personal services, commerce, retailing, government finance and professions. Different other professions are includes under the tertiary sector. Now, as the interdependence, how these three are the interdependent? Primary, secondary, and tertiary. After production of a raw materials in a primary sector, these are moved towards the secondary sector or industries to the means of transport. So both are the interdependent. Primary sector produce as a raw material, secondary sector manufacture the goods based upon a raw materials. So both are interdependent. And for the growth of these two sectors, types of services are required as a banking, insurance, transport, trade. They are the part of tertiary sector. It means primary, secondary, tertiary, all these three are interdependent. And how are the secondary sector, primary sector, they are it is dependent on a secondary sector. Those goods which are manufactured in a secondary sector, like as a machines, tractors, threshers, combines, all these are the products of a secondary sector used as the supportive machinery in agriculture. Fertilizers produced in a secondary sector used as a raw material in a primary sector for a production. Primary sector for production. Fertilizers generally used for increasing the fertility of a soil. So secondary and primary both are the interdependent. So all these three are the interdependent. Without the existence of a one, the others can't produce the goods. First two, primary and secondary, are produced as only the goods, whereas the tertiary sector provides us the services. In economic activities are the highly interdependent. Farmers produce the sugar cane and sell to a sugar mill. If the farmers refuse to sell the sugar cane to them, they will have the sudden shutdown of mill. Under such circumstances, the industrial sector or a secondary sector is dependent on a primary sector. If industry refuses to buy the sugar cane from the farmers, then what will be happen? The farmers, they will face as a losses. Farmers face losses. Coal also. It purchased as a coal for the burning purposes. So all these are purchased by the bakery owner. It also includes as the value of that particular product which manufactured in that industry. Means when the biscuit it sell in a market, it includes the value of all such intermediate goods. Milk, yeast, wheat flour, all their prices, they are included under that particular biscuit which sell in market. Clear? So to solve the confusion regarding as the number of intermediate goods and the money spent on intermediate goods, final goods, the value of a final goods only included under the GDP of the country. GDP of our country. Now, what are the final goods? Final goods, all goods which are meant either for consumption means that particular product which is available in market for the consumption, which can directly consume by the consumers. Consumption, all those goods which are meant either for consumption by consumers or for investment by firms. It means after selling of that particular final product, whatever the earnings earned by the industrialist, it used for the further increasing the production. That is the for investment by firms. The surplus production, the extra production by the industrialist, which produce, sell in market, earn the money, that money has used for the increasing production to the more units, to the purchasing of a more raw material. Clear? So all such goods are the final goods. These goods are the final goods. It is important to note that final use of a product is only for a consumption or investment, not for processing. Final goods are ready for a consumption or either investment. Consumption or investment only. They are not available for the further processing. The other kinds of products are not manufactured from them. These are ready to consume, ready to use as the investment in economy. So these are not resold, nor they enter into the further stages of production. when a good reaches its final user, it becomes a final good. All goods purchased by consumer households are final goods because they are meant for final consumption. All goods purchased by the firms for investment or increasing production. Understood? So these are the final goods. Final goods are their value included under the GDP of a country. Their value included under the GDP of our country. So any questions are, intermediate goods are meant either for further production, means that particular product, it can't consume by the consumers. It require further processing. Further processing means there is a one factory which has only doing as a work of a ginning, separation of a cotton seeds from a cotton balls. So their final product is a cotton balls. Such cotton balls, it can't be as a directly used or consumed by the consumers. It needs as a further processing. Then it will be moved towards the spinning section, spinning towards a weaving factory towards the dyeing processes. So all these are producing their final goods, but these products are not possible to consume. Same as iron smelting centers in blast furnaces, where the impurities of iron ore separated, that pig iron, the molten iron, or iron which has produced by the smelting centers, it can't directly use for the human uses. It needs as a further processing in iron and steel industries to mold in a different shapes in kitchen utensils. Clear? Kitchen utensils. So intermediate goods, they are used for further production or processing. They are used for the resale in the same year. Resale means after the spinning, the thread sale to the weaving section. Then after the making of a cloth, it will be given to the dyeing section or a dyeing factory that will dye in a different number of colors, shades, patterns. Clear? Then it will be given to the others, tailoring, for the tailoring purposes, cutting, stitching. Then the garment which available in a market for the human consumption, for the human use, that is known as a final good, which calculated in a GDP of a country. So intermediate goods are used for further production, means they are used to produce the other goods. They move from one stage of production to the another stage in the manufacture of final product. Raw materials and a semi-finished goods are generally the intermediate goods. Clear? Is that clear?